Hello students, I have explained important points regarding cubes and cube roots in my previous video. Let us start exercise 7.1. In first sum, we will check the given number are perfect cube or not. You have to remember this that in prime factorization of given number, if each factor appears 3 times, then we can say that given number is a perfect cube. We take first number. First number is 216. When we solve 216 by prime factorization method, as you have learned in square, same we solve and we find factors of 216. When we find factor of 216, we get 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3. Now we make group of 3. In square we make pair of factors, but in cube we make group of 3. Look, first group and second group. So we write 216 is equal to 2 cube multiply 3 cube. Here, prime factor 2 and 3 appear in a group of 3. So 216 is a perfect cube. Now we will take next number. Next number is 128. We solve 128 and we get factors of 128. These are the factors of 128. We will make group, first group, second group. Clear? But 2 does not appear in a group. We write 128 is equal to 2 cube multiply 2 cube multiply 2. So, we can say 128 is not a perfect cube because here 2 does not appear in a group. Now we take next number. Next number is 1000. When we find factors of 1000, we find 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 5 multiply 5 multiply 5. When we make groups, first group, second group, and we write 1000 is equal to 2 cube multiply 5 cube. So we can say 1000 is a perfect cube because the prime factor 2 and 5 appear in a group of 3. Clear? Next part, 4th and 5th, you can solve yourself. Now, we will solve next sum. Find the smallest number by which each of the following numbers must be multiplied to obtain a perfect cube. Clear? First number is 243. When we solve 243 by prime factorization method and we get factors of 243, we write 243 is equal to 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3, and we make group, first group. And here, look at here, 3 does not appear in a group because here are only 2 3. So we write here 3 does not appear in a group of 3. So, 243 must be multiplied by 3 to make it a perfect cube. When we multiply 243 by 3, we get 729. And here we write 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 and we multiply by 3. So here group of 3 is first group and second group. So we write 729 is equal to 3 cube multiply 3 cube is equal to 9 cube. Thus 3 is the smallest number by which 243 must be multiplied to get a perfect cube. Clear? Which number does not appear in a group? We multiply given number by that number. So we multiply 243 by 3 because 3 does not appear in a group. We take next number. Next number is 256. We find factors of 256 and we write like this here. First group, second group, and here 2 only 2s. So we write 256 is equal to 2 cube multiply 2 cube multiply 2 multiply 2. Now here does not appear. 2 does not appear in a group of 3. So 256 must be multiplied by 2 to make it a perfect cube. When we multiply 256 by 2, we get group of 2's, first group, second group and third group. So we write 512 is equal to 2 cube multiply 2 cube multiply 2 cube. Thus 2 is the smallest number by which 256 must be multiplied to get a perfect cube. Now we take next number. Next number is 72. We get factors of 72. There are factors of 72. We write 72 is equal to 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 3. Here first group of 2. But 3 does not appear in a group. We write 72 is equal to 2 cube multiply 3 multiply 3. Here 3 does not appear in a group of 3. So 72 must be multiplied by 3 to make it a perfect cube. When we multiply 72 by 3, we get 216. And here when we multiply, we make group first group, second group. We write 216 is equal to 2 cube multiply 3 cube. Thus 3 is the smallest number by which 72 must be multiplied to get a perfect cube. Now part 4th and 5th you can solve yourself. We take next sum. Find the smallest number by which each of the following numbers must be divided to obtain a perfect cube. Here in this sum, we will divide. We take first number. First number is 81. We find out factors of 81 like this. And we find 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3. We make group, first group. Here 3 does not appear in a group of 3. Clear? So 81 must be divided. Clear? Here we will divide. So 81 must be divided by 3 to make it a perfect cube. So we divide by 3 both sides. 81 divided by 3 is equal to 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 and we divide by 3. So we write 3 divided by 3. Now next we get 27 is equal to 3 multiply 3 multiply 3, because when we divide 3 by 3 it becomes 1. Next step, 27 is equal to 3 cube. Thus 3 is the smallest number by which 81 must be divided to get a perfect cube. Now we will take next number. Next number is 128. We find factors of 128 and we write like this. We make group, first group, second group, and here 2 does not appear in a group of 3. So 128 must be divided by 2 to make it a perfect cube. We divide 128 by 2 and we get 64. And here when we divide by 2, when we divide 2 by 2, it becomes 1. So we write 64 is equal to 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 2. And this is first group, this is second group. We write 2 cube multiply 2 cube is equal to 4 cube. Thus 2 is the smallest number by which 128 must be divided to get a perfect cube. Clear? Remaining part, 3rd, 4th, 5th. You can solve yourself. Next sum is, Parikshit makes a cuboid of plasticine of sides 5 cm, 2 cm and 5 cm. How many such cuboids will he need to form a cube? Here, sides of cubes are given 5 cm, 2 cm and 5 cm. As you know, volume of the cuboid is L multiply B multiply H. L means length, B means breadth, H means height. So we write 5 cm multiply 2 cm multiply 5 cm. Look at here. Here 5 and 2 both are not in a group of 3. Here 2 5s and here only 1 2. So we write here factors of 5 and 2 both are not in a group of 3. Therefore, the number must be multiplied by 5 multiply 2 multiply 2 is equal to 20 to make it a perfect cube. Thus, Parikshit needs 20 cuboids. Clear? Okay. Exercise 7.1 is over. I hope you have understood. We will start exercise 7.2 in my next video. Thank you.